Hello and welcome back to Proactive. It is Friday and that means it's time for this week's Crypto Roundup with William Farrington. William, good to see you.
You too. How are you doing, Tom?
I'm very, very well. Now, last week we were chatting a bit about the difficult relationship now between crypto companies and sports teams. Mm-hmm. And lo, it has come to pass that the Amber Group has had to pull out of a sponsorship agreement with Chelsea Football Club.
Yeah, that's right. Slight background on Amber Group. It comprises ex-Morgan Stanley traders. It's backed by the Singapore government. It has been looking for a $100 million investment round recently. And you may have noticed on Chelsea FC's kit, whale fin, the whale fin logo. That's essentially Amber Group's sponsorship. That's Amber Group's application. So Amber Group has had a sponsorship deal with Chelsea for a while. I think it's about a £20 million yearly deal with Chelsea. And it's essentially just announced that it's pulling out of that deal. So it's quite a major upset in the world of crypto sports sponsorship deals. You know, as we were discussing last week, there's been a real exodus of crypto firms from the Formula One and from football. And this is just another indication that we're seeing, yeah, something of an exodus from previously high-profile crypto companies sponsoring sport teams. Though that said, you may have seen the crypto.com logos and the World Cup, so that's still there, but I'm not sure if it's going to be there for the next World Cup.
I guess we'll see. You mentioned to me before we came on air that you think that the Grayscale Bitcoin Trust is a good bellwether for the situation at the moment. So what would you like to say about that?
Yeah, so Grayscale Bitcoin Trust, it's the largest trust of its kind. Essentially, it's an investment vehicle, 100% invested in Bitcoin. It's got about $10.7 billion in assets under management. So yeah, it comprises about 850,000 investors. So it really is, as you just said, it can be seen as a bit of a bellwether for sentiment among the Bitcoin investment community. And well, if we're looking at performance, it just keeps hitting record lows. So the trust is at about a 50% discount to the price of Bitcoin right now. By that, I mean the people invested in Grayscale Bitcoin Trust, their shares are worth 50% less than the price of Bitcoin. So that just shows the sentiment among the investment community to trust like this. So it's really bad news for the existing investors in Grayscale, compounded by the fact that they can't actually redeem their shares if they want to, because the way the trust is designed, they don't allow for redemptions. So you have to sell your shares on if you can find a buyer, right? But hey, look, ARK Investments, Cathie Wood, your very famous investor, she's just bought the dip on Grayscale Bitcoin Trust. So she's put her weight behind it. That's a bit of a promising sign. And actually, I was just looking at asset fund inflows, and we've seen net positive inflows across all Bitcoin asset funds in the past week. Very minimal, about $10 million. But that at least shows that some are seeing that we're at the bottom and, potentially seeing forward momentum in the price of Bitcoin to come.
Well, I can think of somebody that might like a bit of forward momentum at the moment, and that is Sam Friedman, because it's had a terrible year. So do you have an update for us about what's been going on with FTX?
Yeah, well, that story changes day to day, doesn't it? The latest news was, so he was summoned before Congress to appear at a hearing, to discuss what's going on. And well, the deadline for that hearing to accept that hearing came today, and it has passed. So he's basically snubbed Congress. He remains holed up in the Bahamas on various potential charges. One of the biggest recent developments, though, is the fact that US prosecutors have just opened an investigation into market manipulation all the way back in May. So Sam Bankman-Fried, essentially, has already been blamed for one massive crypto collapse. That's when FTX collapsed in November. But now US prosecutors are looking into the potential that he in some way manipulated the market to to preempt the crash of the Luna and UST tokens, which basically caused the $2 trillion market rout that we saw throughout the year. So the fact that he's at the center now of two huge crashes on the crypto markets in 2022, it's just nuts, the potential influence that this guy may have had on all the woes that we've seen on the market. Obviously, these are still just accusations.
All right. Well, I think he might be better off just staying there in the Bahamas. And, you know, he probably might even go and join him. You never know.
Yeah, it's good this time of year, I hear.
Yeah, I bet. All right, then, Billy. Well, thank you very much for the update anyway. And I'll catch you again next Friday.
No problem. See ya.